All right, before we begin, I'm going to ask two questions from the audience because my topic is on AI, which is artificial intelligence. How many people in this room, it's okay, be honest, raise your hands if you feel comfortable that you know what artificial intelligence really is? Okay. All right. Second question. How many of you feel comfortable that you interact with AI on a day-to-day basis? All right. Fantastic. Then this is going to be a good one. Every day, globally, we create 120 zettabytes of data. It has become necessary that we use artificial intelligence just so we can process big data so that we can generate more questions with more answers with a high level of confidence. Yet in 2023, by the Pew Research Center Foundation, 44% of Americans do not believe that they interact regularly with AI. AI is already here. It is embedded in everything that you do on a day-to-day basis, whether you realize it or not. Now, often it has no major impact. Recommendations for online shopping, your home security system sending you notifications, or maybe that fitness app that you're wearing that monitors your sleeping patterns. But what about who determines who receives a credit card, a mortgage, or the diagnostic results in your x-rays? AI technologies are used in every one of those scenarios, and those decisions can have a major impact on how we live our lives. For example, in 2020, the study with the Journal of Internal Medicine found that some hospitals who use kidney transplant software to prioritize recipients had discriminated against non-white male patients. Now, this bias was because of the data training the software included information from almost all white male patients. Therefore, no other demographic was considered in those prioritization results. Should we be concerned? If you are, you're not alone. AI technologies use AI models, which are mathematical algorithms. It is an interface or a chatbot that gives us human-like responses to our questions. But there's a perception that if we're using AI technologies, then it must be trustworthy because a machine was involved. But the opposite is more likely because it was a human that collected the data, and it was a human that trained and tested the results that enabled the machine to answer those questions. Often, we don't know what we don't know. We don't know what questions to ask, and if we are asking questions, we're not entirely sure if we're asking the right ones. This is why AI literacy for the global citizen is absolutely critical today. An AI literate citizen is someone who knows what and how much data they are creating. It is someone who feels confident that how their personal data is being stored, shared, deleted, and sold to a third party. An AI literate citizen is someone who knows what and how much data is being created on a day-to-day basis. It is someone who recognizes how their personal data is being stored, shared, deleted, and sold to a third party. It is someone who feels confident that they know how that information is being consumed on a day-to-day basis in the products and services that you're interacting with. But more importantly, it's understanding its limitations, because all those products and services you're consuming, they're only as good as the data used to train them. Let's take ChatGPT version 4. That was released this year in March of 2023. Now, ChatGPT is a chatbot, you know, that human interface. It's answering questions with human-like responses. Earlier this year, a U.S. senator made news because he used ChatGPT to automatically generate his entire speech for an opening statement on a Senate hearing on the topic of generative AI. Now, I asked ChatGPT, give me a short, funny poem about losing a puppy written by a 10-year-old girl. I got the responses back in less than 10 seconds. And I have to admit, the feedback and the response was far better than what I could have created on my own. But there's two important things that we need to listen here. Two things that's going to be critical in how you think about AI going forward. One, the data used to train ChatGPT version 4 was mostly used from publicly available data, like the internet. You contributed to training ChatGPT version 4. You contributed to the 120 zettabytes of data that's created every day from your likes, your posts, your uploads of videos and articles that you're writing. Two, the data used to train ChatGPT 4 stopped as of September 2021. But yet it was released this year in 2023. This data creates an understanding that my results were used from information prior to 2021, which means that anything after 2021 wasn't considered in my answers, which also means, depending on the question I'm asking, the results could be obsolete. They could be inaccurate or just completely wrong. But understanding these limitations is what helps us know what questions to ask. There's another perception around AI technologies that we're losing a lot of jobs because AI is taking away some of those positions. And there's another perception that women are being more impacted by those job losses. We are losing more jobs. I will admit that. The answer is yes. We are losing more jobs to AI technologies than ever before, but we're gaining more jobs than what we're losing. And those women who have been on the internet referenced in losing their jobs in marketing and HR functions, it is the same women that are being hired by those startups to train and test those AI models, which is then automating the marketing and HR functions. Women are leading the way in those new jobs. They're accepting positions as data scientists, quality assurance, and chief data officers. But more importantly, women are building data and AI organizations from the ground up in the private sector. But it's in the public sector where women are outnumbering men in health, education, and public administrative positions. 63% women to 37% men. And it's in the public sector that's really, really important because here is where AI policies and regulations are being debated and written and enforced. And it's here where AI regulations are going to be explored and communicated to the rest of the world. Even today, we still don't have clear policies and regulations around AI that would ensure confidence in how AI is being used. But in the public sector, we're sharing information in local and federal agencies, which is going to impact security, transportation, and trust. So why are women having so much influence in the AI sector? Women are problem solvers. They explore the unknown. They are willing to seek out new information. This resiliency and their ability to adapt, this is what allows women to become and continue to be a force in the AI sector today, tomorrow, and beyond. But more importantly, it is why women are going to be the influencer in how we all understand how to become a better informed AI global citizen. Thank you.